What's up, guys and dolls? Today we're going to be reviewing another really gorgeous wig from the company Diva Wigs. They sent over this beautiful box for me. There is an instruction manual with all the details, wig cap, brush with their logo and bows, and then here is the beautiful packaging for the wig. Now they sent over this gorgeous, like nice, rich brown. It's like brown with different highlights and different colors, almost like a honey tone. This is what the wig looks like on the inside. What's really cool is that the wig comes pre-bleached. Yes, you will have your knots bleached for you. Now here's a handful of products I'm going to be using to slay my wig. And here I am just showing you a little clip of what the hairline looks like and the parting. Again, they bleached the knots for you, and then the front is pre-plucked. The wig itself is a Malaysian straight wig. It is 100% Malaysian hair. The wig itself is 360 lace front wig cap. I got it in a size petite, and I got my lace in a colored medium brown. So you see there, my freaking clip just broke on me out of nowhere. But first of all, I'm going to go ahead and get all of the hair out of the way, cut off the lace, and begin to work on the baby hair. Now you can do it in whatever steps work best for you, but I kind of find that like remove the lace, bond it down, do the baby hair, and then I style it last. Some people will like bond it down and style it and do the baby hair last, but I just like to work from the front to the back, I guess. Make sure that you are cutting the lace around your ear so that it sits perfectly on that thing. I did the other side off of camera, and then I applied my Holy Grail free spray from Got to Be Glued. Keep in mind that if you are going to be tweezing, plucking, tweezing, doing the pull method on the hairline, do that before you add the Got to Be Glue, just because you will find that because it's not a permanent glue, it will move if you tug too much. So here I applied it the first time, and I let it sit for way too long. And the downside to that is it didn't stick, so I had to reapply the free spray, let it sit for about 15 seconds to get a little bit tacky, and then cover it with the lace. Now, you guys have seen in the last couple of videos, I've been using the blow dryer, and it's almost a step I can't live without, because if you've been doing it without the blow dryer before and you tried the blow dryer, you will see how tighter of a hold, like the wig feels tight on your head. Not tight like it's suffocating you, but just it feels like it's been bonded down or sewn down. It just feels really, really, really good and secure, if that makes any sense. The only downside is that it does go ahead and leave this white cast that you see here. That is very messy, in my opinion. It doesn't give you a clean finish. So I am trying to figure out what I can do to prevent this. Maybe if I don't actually touch or press on the area while it is being blow-dried, that may help. Also, I have seen that a lot of people will use spritz. I do have some in the cabinet, so I'm going to try that maybe later today on another application and see if the spritz works better. But it's all about trial and error, because I'm just finding that the blow dryer is something that I need, but my baby hair and the hairline just doesn't look as good as it normally does if I don't use a blow dryer, yet the wig is bonded much better. Hopefully I'm making sense. Can you see the highlights in this hair? This wig is so gorgeous. I'm absolutely thinking about wearing this for the next, like, the rest of the month, just because I love, love, love the way this color comes up on me. Brown girls sometimes think that we cannot do color. This is kind of one of those entryway colors that, you know, if you're used to doing natural colors and dark colors and blacks, this is kind of one of those lighter brown shades that will kind of introduce you to color and kind of help you, you know, get used to it. It's also a nice, perfect fall, you know, look, in my opinion. Now, I feel like I'm either doing my baby hair super heavy or super duper duper light, and I don't have that in between. So next time I will do the baby hair a little bit lighter. I also find that when you add powder to the parting and to the baby hair after you do the baby hair, this part, it makes it like look a little bit more thin and natural. So that's a step that you can use, but in my case, I didn't need any powder in the parting because, again, it is bleached for me. And you just work on that and take your time to get the look that you desire. I'm pretty happy with it. There is a white cast, but we're gonna cancel that out with a little bit of oil at the very end of this video. But for now, we're gonna get to styling. I'm absolutely loving this wig. I just think it complements my complexion so well. Now, Diva Wigs is a company that I've worked with many times, so if you like this wig but maybe it's not for you, you can go into my hair reviews, Ashley's hair review playlist, and just type in the search bar Diva's Wigs, and all of the reviews I've done for this company will come up, and you can see other options that I've done and kind of get an idea of some of their wigs and how they look and work and all that stuff, so that you can decide the best look for you. Now, I kind of took my time to decide on the perfect parting. I knew I wanted a deep side part, so I kind of did a little bit over and seen how that looked and smoothed it out, flattened it out, and then I wanted a little bit more, so I did the same step again. And just really getting there close to the root as possible really helps to have a flat wig. Also, be sure to kind of curve around where the tracks start and like the lace ends and kind of those two meet, and kind of do a little bit of a part that'll help to make sure that no matter what way the wind blows, you will never have to worry about your tracks showing. And I use a little bit of mousse to kind of help me to hold that in place, and also a little bit of heat. Here, I really can't see, so make sure you use a mirror, or use bae or a friend to kind of make sure to help you see, or just take a picture with your camera to make sure that all the tracks are covered, because there are times that I do the step and I think I covered the tracks and then I find out later that I didn't. But this is just going to help to kind of, even if you push the remainder of that bang backwards, if it slides or moves, you know for sure that no matter what happens, that track is covered. So I'm using my Sebastian Shapers on the very front of the hairline and kind of going against the grain and kind of smoothing that out. I kind of want to have a little height in the front, and this is going to help it to have that nice, you see how it kind of gives it a nice bit of height and body. And then I decided I wanted a side bang. This is kind of a look from like the 2000s, maybe even the 90s. This is just something that my mom used to do with her natural hair. She'd wear like in a straight wrap, and then she'd do like a deep part sometimes with a huge curl, and then she kind of flip it backwards and do the feather. That was literally like her signature look. And then even in high school, my generation, we kind of did it a little bit different, basically the same, but we would cut that bang like almost to like the top of our nose, or maybe the bottom of our nose, so it would be shorter than the rest of the hair, but it kind of was a look. Here I'm adding a little bit of a finishing spray. It's going to kind of make it all sit down, and any flyaways are just going to not move at all. And that's pretty much it. This was a really quick and easy look. I love it when companies send me colored wigs, because it's easy to go ahead and style it and not have to really think of a style or so of what I want to do with it. Also really special about this one is the knots were bleached. So even though I went ahead and customized the baby hair, I didn't have to go ahead and customize the knots or add powder to the parting at all. There is a little bit of a white cast. I'm going to just take a little bit of an oil sheen and kind of just press that in. And for the most part, that'll get rid of that with no problem. Also, I've implemented the step of the blow dryer when it comes to bonding my wig down with the Got To Be Glue. And it leaves a white cast whenever you use the blow dryer, but it just works so well to bond the wig down that it's kind of like, I want to do it because it bonds the wig down, but then I don't want the white cast. So, just be warned. If you do use the blow dryer on a cool setting and you're using the Got To Be Glued, it is going to leave you a white cast. Also, I added a little bit of a curl because it had a side part, but I kind of customized it and moved it over. I really don't want the wig to be curly. I just wanted to add something, like some definition to that there. That swoop. And I think that looks super good. I probably could have brought it over even more because I kind of like a deep part, but this will do for now. The color is amazing. All the details on this wig are listed in the description bar. Hope you guys enjoyed this one here. Thank you guys so much for watching. We are almost at 100k. I think we are less than 5k away, so make sure that you are subscribed
Tell everybody that you know to subscribe. Take your kids' iPads and subscribe. Take your mama's iPad. Take everybody you know, iPad, phone, whoever got a YouTube account, add me and subscribe, because I am trying to hit 100K before the month of October is up. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I'll see you in the next one.